So Ben, how you doing, my friend?
Doing very well.
You look very well.
I'm happy to be here, my man.
Seriously.
Seriously. I'm not only an Arsenal fan, but I'm a football fan because of you.
Seriously, man.
Yes.
You look at my face. It's going all funny.
Yeah,
you're
I'm getting all bashful and that, you know. you're my first hero.
Seriously.
Yeah, after He-Man, who's not real. He's a fictional character.
I'm pleased.
Yeah.
I hope that anything that I could have done has made you go in the right direction. That's all you can do. Because people constantly talk about role models, and I'm sure that you're one of those, and that you're in that bracket. People constantly talk about it, and all you want to do is hopefully make people off of the back of what you do is just go in the right direction.
Yeah, well, you inspired me to want to be a footballer until I found alcohol and women and music. And then it all went.
What position would you have played, Ben? What position?
I played left wing.
Are you left footed then?
Left footed, yeah.
Are you one of those smooth left footers?
Do you know what? I was like Freddie Ljungberg. I had to work at it. I had a lot of determination.
Yeah.
But maybe didn't have the most natural of technical ability.
What did you most like doing? Taking people on or scoring or crossing? What was your main thing?
All of those things. Taking people on. Setting up goals and obviously scoring. But, I was a goal-scoring midfielder.
You know? Like David Platt and Frank Lampard kind of vibe.
Yeah, that kind of vibe.
We mentioned football and the Arsenal, of course, the great Arsenal. When did it start for you? Because, like you mentioned, from East London, how come you supported Arsenal?
Yeah, I should have supported West Ham. I live right next to
Because Ray's a West Ham man. Did you have a banner about that?
He is, yeah. I mean, I didn't have a dad around, you know, when I was a kid. So, I had no brothers. You
to
know.
Take you?
No one to like actually play the sport with me
and
get me into the sport. So, I had a mate of mine I grew up with. He was like a mate of the family. His mum was friends with my mum.
Yeah.
He used to come around sometimes. And he said, right, Arsenal and Tottenham are playing. He goes, whoever wins out of these two teams, I'm going to support.
Yeah.
And I said, oh, okay, all right, well, I'll do the same. And Arsenal won, 1-0, right? So I became an Arsenal fan, not knowing much about them or football or anything. And then I then watched Arsenal v Sheffield Wednesday. It was...
Was it a final or something?
It was the Coca-Cola Cup.
Yeah. Mayor scored,
I think. It was the final. And then you played them, we played them the week after in the FA Cup.
Something like that. It was a little, yeah.
Yeah? So it's two finals and... I watched you playing them.
Yeah.
And I just, as a player, I fell in love with you, you know. I'll say it, you know, as I did. And after that, it was Arsenal all the way.
Do you keep up to speed with what they're doing now? Like, because I get a lot of stick off Arsenal fans because I say I don't know when we're going to be able to compete at right at the top end again because we're selling players. Players want to leave. They're talking about Theo now. He's apparently going to stay, but does that mean he's going to leave later on?
I don't fully understand the politics going on in that club. You know, I know we had the new stadium and that... I just think, what's the point of having a new stadium if we're not going to compete at that level? If we're still paying off the stadium, you know, like, what was the point of building it? Couldn't we have just stayed at Highbury and, you know, spent that money on players?
Ben was a corporate side of it was because the amount of people that they could get into the stadium, and if they can get a team that can compete to qualify in fourth, then the money's generated by that will continuously.
But it's
pay
not.
The stadium back
but it's
rocks,
not. It's not. Know? It's not paying for the stuff we need now. And
we're
turning into Everton.
Everton, but I wish we could turn into Everton. I mean, they're on fire at the moment.
No, but like maybe at the moment. But I'm in terms of a mid-table club that's been mid-table for the last 20 years.
Yeah, I've been. Yeah, and we're in danger of that. They've got to understand that. Selling Robin van Persie. Did you see him in the United shirt? How weird was that?
Well, what upset me is when he said, you know, it's my boyhood dream to be, you know, a Man U player and, you know, I feel really at home here. And it's like, just have a bit of decorum, mate. Do you know what I mean? Because, you know, if we did have the money and if we were buying the players, you would have stayed with us. Yeah. You know what I mean?
So whose fault is it then? Is it his fault or is it
I think it's the board. I think Arsene Wenger is hiding things.
I think he's a company man, personally. I think that he's hiding fact. He's not... There's people...
Maybe he has a stake in the club that we don't know about. Maybe he has a business stake in the club and maybe that's part of it. You know, but... I mean, if he goes, who are we going to get?
Exactly.
What's going on at Liverpool here where you've got...
Brendan Rodgers.
Yeah, but and the geezer before that is now the England manager.
Oh, Roy Hodgson.
Yeah, I never remember his name. They had Kenny before
Kenny,
that.
Yeah, Kenny.
And they'd just been like, I don't know, if we lose Wenger, that's what's going to happen. We're going to get, you know, the next geezer who's just promoted some club from League One into the Premiership, you know, and then he'll last a season, then we'll get like, I don't know, Gordon Strachan for a season, or do you know, it was going to turn into that. I just think like we moan about Wenger, but who else is going to come in?
Exactly.
Because someone like Jose Mourinho is not going to come into Arsenal with these kind of financial restraints.
Pep Guardiola, Arsenal fans are saying someone like Pep Guardiola.
But he won't, because he'll speak to the board and he'll say, how much money have I got to spend? And they'll say nothing. And they'll go, no, thank you.
And the thing is, it is a shame. But and, you know, we'll have to go on.
Sorry, last thing is this, right? Arsene Wenger, when he came to Arsenal, he poached a load of young players. I don't want to say poached, but he got them for really cheap. It was like the rest of the world, or French football was his academy of football that he was sourcing from. And now he's become that for the rest of the Premiership. And I think that's the most depressing thing.
Yeah, on that note.
Lovely. My man.
Hey, well said. You got a sign, my Arsenal top.
No worries, man.